We want to determine the domain and the range of f of x given the graph of f of x. We also want to write the answer using interval notation and as a compound inequality. The domain of a function is a set of all possible inputs or x values. So to determine the domain of the function, we'll analyze the graph from left to right since the x values run from left to right. And the range of a function is a set of all possible outputs or y values, also the function values. And since the y values run vertically, we'll analyze this graph vertically to determine the range of the function. Let's begin by determining the domain, which would be the set of all possible x values. If we were to project this graph onto the x-axis, or think how far left and how far right the graph goes, notice how it starts at negative 6, but because of the open point, it does not include negative 6. But then from there, it goes from negative 6 all the way to positive 4. But again, because of this open point here, it does not include positive 4. So the domain of the function is the open interval from negative 6 to positive 4. So using interval notation, we would have a rounded parenthesis, negative 6, comma, 4, rounded parenthesis. Remember, these rounded parentheses indicate that the endpoints are not included. And as a compound inequality, we can say that x is greater than negative 6, not greater than or equal to, because again, it does not include negative 6, and x is also less than 4. So here's the domain using interval notation, as well as using a compound inequality. And now we'll analyze the graph vertically to determine the range. Notice the lowest point on the graph would be this point here, where the y value is negative 5. Because this point is closed, it does include the value of y equals negative 5. So the range starts at negative 5, including negative 5. There are no holes and breaks in the graph, and the highest point in the graph would be this point here, where notice that y is positive 4. Again, this is a closed point, so y equals 4 is in the range, and therefore the range is the closed interval from negative 5 to positive 4. So using interval notation, we would now use square brackets to make sure that the endpoints are included. So square bracket negative 5 comma 4. And now for the compound inequality, because we're talking about the range, we'll use y instead of x. So y is greater than or equal to negative 5 and less than or equal to positive 4. This would be the domain and the range of the given function. I hope you found this helpful.